My name is Christian Chavez, and I attend the Rolling Meadows campus. I've pretty much stuttered my whole life. Because of my stuttering, I was never really accepted. The neighborhood I lived in was full of gangs. I mean, that's what it was, gangs and drugs, really. I was a bad kid. I started doing drugs seventh grade. I got my first tattoo in seventh grade. Our bus driver would allow us to smoke cigarettes on the bus. A couple of people had some weed on there, and we were literally smoking weed on the school bus. My sister was involved with the gangs. I was home, and there were cops knocking. And cops knocking at our house wasn't something new. They told us what happened. She was shot dead and murdered when she was 18 years old. And telling my mom that my sister was murdered was one of the hardest things I had to do. And that just shook my whole life. I met Rita in high school. We started getting serious my junior year.
At that point, we were just dating, living for ourselves. A lot of drinking, a lot of partying, a lot of bad decisions, one after another.
We're driving down the road. One of our friends waved us down. He said he was about to get into a fight with some guys. I brought out a baseball bat. Cops showed up, officers found me there, and when I was being handcuffed, I pushed it back, and after that, it was chaos. I was punched, I was kicked in the head, punched in the face. I went to jail for a week. I mean, I was in jail when I was 17 years old. Once I got out, my first time, I told myself I am never going back there. But there was one night where I was hanging out with some friends, a lot of drinking going on. One of my friend's friends showed up, and when I was trying to leave, I remember him saying, "Don't be stupid, don't drive. I'm not stupid, don't call me stupid." So I ended up picking up a bottle off the floor, and I was beating him over his head with it. When his friends came out, I don't know what happened. I woke up in the hospital. My ankle was out like this. My face was totally swollen. And they wouldn't give me any painkillers because I was so drunk. I was sentenced to 40 days in jail. I mean, I was 26 years old now, right? I was a mess. I was mad. I was angry. My way's not working. My way's not working at all.
The Lord really took him to a really low spot in his life and kind of took me down with him as well. This is not what I pictured our life to be like. It was devastating.
She pretty much left me, you know? I was by myself in a dark place. I mean, that place was dark and evil. I can't do this on my own. I mean, I can't. And I met this one guy, and he was just telling me about Jesus. We would, you know, talk about God and talk about God's love, and I was learning who God truly was, you know? I was laying in my bunk. I prayed, and I'm like, I can't do this on my own. Take me. I mean, I'm yours, you know? I gave my life to God. I gave up, and I'm like, it's yours, you know?
He grew up not having church in his life at all. So for him to say that he wanted to start going to church was like, really? Like, you want to go to church? Like, sure, let's do it.
Harvest was pretty much off the highway. I knew nothing about Harvest other than it was this warehouse back in the, you know, 80s. The sermons they just hit home every single week.
We weren't married at the time. We were living in sin, and you know, one day my husband or boyfriend at the time looks at me. He's like, "We need to get married. We need to make this right in front of God." And to me, that was like, "What? Like, this is just who this is coming out of your mouth. Like, there's no way.
Got married, you know, at Harvest. I mean, we've been married now 10 years. Our marriage is based on God's foundation. I mean, without that foundation, our marriage would be a hot mess.
I consider my husband and I like first generation Christians in our family, and just to be able to raise up our kids with something that him and I never had growing up is just such a gift.
My girls, they're learning God's word. One of my friends was like, oh, you know, Rita, you know, totally, you know, got you out of that. And I'm kind of like thinking like, no, God got me out of that. It wasn't Rita. I mean, wasn't me doing it. It was a God thing. I also had a friend. He was like, yeah, if I was to bet on like people that were like, you know, not gonna make it, you were probably that guy that was not gonna make it. It's like, well, thank God for that, you know?